In a previous Excel video, we showed how it was usually best to specify constants outside an Excel data table rather than repeating them in each row or column. But for this to work, you need to understand the difference between relative and absolute cell references. Here's a simple table showing the scores for a group of people. To get the total for each person, all you need to do is to use the sum tool. Enter score 1 plus score 2, then pull the formula down and each score is calculated. See how the cell reference has moved relative to each line. That's because Excel uses a relative reference. But if you want each calculation to refer to a constant in the same cell, you need to tell Excel to use an absolute reference. There are two ways to make Excel refer to a constant as an absolute reference. One way is to add the dollar sign before either the row or the column number, or both. Adding a dollar sign before the row number, like this, makes the row a constant but keeps the column relative. A dollar sign before the column letter keeps the column constant but the row relative. And a dollar sign before both keeps both row and column fixed as constants. An example might be when you're applying sale tax to a set of prices. Here's an extract from a list of products with their unit price. You'll see that there are three different tax rates. Suppose the tax rates change. Imagine having to change every line in a table with hundreds of entries. A long and boring job, and a recipe for making a mistake. It's much easier to define those tax rates externally as constants and create a reference to those external constants in your table. That way, you only need to change each tax rate once, should there be a change. And here's the completed table. See how, by changing a single constant cell, all the related calculations are changed automatically. But you'll never remember which cell reference to add, so you'll probably have to look back at the constants every time you want to add them to the function or formula to check their proper address. A much better way is to give each constant cell a unique name and to refer to that name rather than the usual row and column reference. That way, you don't have to keep checking the reference's address. Here's how it's done. At the top left of the navigation bar, find the cell name and select it. Type a unique reference name, something that you'll recognize, and press Enter, and it's done. Now you can refer to that cell by name, and you'll get an absolute reference to it. It's so much easier to work with. So let's complete our table using an absolute reference with those names. Bingo. Job done. eTop Technology. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our more recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.